in about 18 minutes, so I'm looking forward to seeing what Buck's take is on this. But one of the things that we had a complaint about last show, or yesterday, was why $5 million? $5 million is a slap on the wrist
right.
to a guy like Jim Crane. I call it ashtray money. Probably has ashtray money in his car with that kind of money. He's a billionaire.
Sure.
So $5 million is nothing. That's the most that he could be fined. It's in the MLB Constitution. So, and who writes the Constitution? The owners. You think the owners want to be zapped with a $50 million fine?
So think of how disingenuous this whole punishment is, right? And how hogtied, for lack of a better word, that you have, or phrase, that you have if you're Manfred. Right, you can't really go after the owner because you can't give more than a $5 million fine, right? You can't go after the players because they're protected by the union. So the general manager and the manager get banned for a year and then eventually lose their jobs. So the punishment just basically comes with, who am I allowed to punish? Because I'm able to punish the unprotected. The owners are protected by themselves, so they come up with this Fugazi rule that nobody can be fined more than $5 million. They're snickering to themselves, right?
Right.
Because they can't really be touched. The players can't be touched. So I'm not saying that managers and general managers don't deserve to be punished, but do they deserve to be punished because they're the only ones that aren't protected? That's not fair, man.
Yeah, it's weird, and it puts the onus on the Mets, too, because, you know, we did some background work, and Beltran was interviewed by the Mets and hired by the Mets before any of this came out, before the Athletic piece came out. So they could be excused for not asking during the interview because, obviously, they didn't know.
But why was he asked at the press conference?
He wasn't asked at the press conference. He was asked in a text right after it broke from Joel Sherman, and he lied to Joel. But he told the truth to the investigators. So now, what do the Mets do? Do they want to be stained by a guy, the only player that was named? Now, you could say that no player was punished, but the fact that his name was used, well, that's punishment.
Because
this is a guy with a totally pristine reputation, and that reputation is now shot.
Listen, they can get up from it and say, why should I discipline Beltran? He wasn't disciplined by Major League Baseball.
Mm-hmm.
But he was named in the investigation.
More than implicated.
And everybody that was named in the investigation has been disciplined except him. So obviously...
And Cora,
Cora is going to be. And if the Red Sox fire Cora, then the Mets will probably feel the pressure to do the same with Beltran, unless they decide to fight and say, Cora was disciplined by baseball, Hinch was disciplined by baseball, Lunau was disciplined by MLB, that's why they were fired. Our guy wasn't disciplined, so we're not going to fire him. But the subplot to this, to me, and I was reading a lot on Twitter, just trying to get the public reaction. We know the Mets are one of those teams that seems to listen to their fan base. A lot of Met fans are upset. A lot of Met fans feel
that surprises me when you told me that.
They, you know, listen, it's not everybody, Michael, and I don't know what the percentage is, but you're hearing, I don't want a cheater on my team. He's a liar. So if the fan base turns on Beltran, remember, a lot of PR was done behind the hiring of Carlos Beltran. I'm not saying that he's not a good baseball person, but let's face it. I mean, I think the Mets hired him because he was a name. But now that name has been sullied, so do they get the PR hit they thought they were going to get by hiring him? Are people going to buy tickets? Or is this going to be some negative public relations because now they have cheater on their team? Now they have a liar on their team. So it really depends on how the Wilpons feel, and also how does Steve Cohen feel? He didn't hire Beltran.
Mm-hmm.
This all happened before him, but now he's the owner of the team. Does he want to have him on?
Now, one thing that's interesting, after this all came out and Carlos had been hired, Brody Van Wagner said, I don't care what happened. It happened on another team, not on this team. But still, it kind of paints the way you are looked at. And Don brings up a good point. He was hired for his squeaky clean nature, the fact that everybody loved him in baseball, and they still do. And you know, I told you that I'm biased in this because he's a great guy, but he did something wrong. And the players just scoot away scot-free. So yesterday, I'm not a big fan of rewriting history. It happened. That's all there is to it. But I was talking to a lot of people around baseball. I was watching the game yesterday. And a lot of people really feel the Astros got off very easily.
That's how I feel.
And they felt that there's no way Jim Crane should have skated this much. There's just no way. If Jeff Lunau was responsible for what went on in the clubhouse, then Jim Crane has to be responsible for the atmosphere and the culture that he set in his front office, which in the ruling Rob Manfred said was a bad culture. Well, the culture is something that the owner has to set. He obviously set a really, really bad culture. And he gets away scot-free looking like the White Knight because he fired A.J. Hinch and Jeff Lunau. He got away with a slap on the wrist. Now, another thing a lot of people in baseball think, and David Cohn said this on the Yes Hot Stove show yesterday, he feels the championship should be taken away. Now, again, I'm not a fan of rewriting history, but why should the people that are on that Astro team have the right to call themselves world champions? How should they have the right to flaunt their rings and say, listen, we did it. Nobody else could do it. I'm not saying give the championship to the Dodgers, who they lost to in the World Series, or the Dodgers lost to them in the World Series, or the Yankees, who won seven games. Don't give it to anybody. And there is precedent, by the way. There is not a champion in 1994 because they did not play a World Series. So if you vacate that title, then you take away a lot of the luster that the Astros have. And the players, although they're not punished, now Justin Verlander all of a sudden doesn't have a world championship on his resume. Alex Bregman doesn't. Altuve doesn't. Correa doesn't. And that means something to these players. I truly believe with all the money in sports, these guys want to be champions. It's important to them.
Right. Now, they're not going to forfeit their rings, and they can walk around saying, we won the championship. But part of winning a championship, Michael, and you've talked about this a bunch of times, it's part of forever.
Yep.
You will be a champion forever. No matter what people say, no matter what happens in the future, somebody will look back into a computer in a book somewhere, and they'll say 2017 Houston Astros champions. 200 years from now, they can look up, and they'll see a vacancy. Investigate further. Why was there no champion award in 2017? Because the team that won cheated. And that will be a part of forever. So winning a championship is supposed to be a part of forever. Having it taken away from you is now a stain that will last there forever. So I wasn't a big fan of it either back when college teams were doing it.
No,
but now the more that I think about it, I believe it should be part of the ruling against cheating is that you vacate that title.
And like I said yesterday, it means the most when it's your only one.
And when people debate this, they go, well, they didn't take titles away from teams that had guys that did roids. Okay. That doesn't mean that they won the title. And a lot of people are saying, and this is a legitimate point, Yankee fans, why should you complain? You scored three runs in the four games in Houston, and that's in the ALCS. But the point is this. They won the three games at Yankee Stadium. The fact that the Astros cheated throughout the season gave them a better record throughout the season. The Yankees might have had the four games at Yankee Stadium.
Correct.
And they could be champions of 2017.
Correct.
So it affects a lot of people.
And here's the difference between